Let's look at a few examples where we practice the distributive property. Here's our first example. We have the quantity 4 plus k minus the quantity 1 plus 3k. Now, right off the bat, it doesn't appear to have a distributive property because we don't really see a clear-cut number outside one of our parentheses, like a 3 or something like that, that would need to be distributed. But in fact, there is. It's just a little hard to spot. This minus sign right here is actually, you could think of it as plus negative 1. You could think of minus as plus negative 1 times the quantity 1 plus 3k. So the distributive property is applicable here. We would need to distribute this negative throughout the last two terms. The first two terms do not have a distributive property, but the second terms do. So this would give us 4 plus k, since there's no distributive property, we can just drop the parentheses. Then we can say minus 1 minus 3k, because you have to remember when you distribute this negative, the negative goes in for both terms here. Now, just as a side note, not to get off on a tangent here, if this plus sign had been a minus, then a minus a negative would have turned this into a plus. It wasn't, but I'm just saying if it was, a negative negative would have made a positive, but that's not what we have. So anyway, we're almost done. This is definitely the right next step. So from here, all we have to do is simplify our answer. I see like terms of the 4 and the negative 1, the two constants. 4 minus 1 gives me 3, and k minus 3k is like, or both of those are like terms, so that would yield minus 2k. So this would be our final answer after distributing the negative and combining like terms. All right, here we have a distributive property with three terms. We have negative 7 times the quantity 2 plus 3a minus b. So what we'll do is we'll take this negative 7 and we'll distribute it to the first, the second, and the third term, and that's totally allowed. You're totally allowed to do that. So we would get minus 14. That's negative 7 times 2. And then negative 7 times 3a would give us negative 21a. So we would have minus 21a. And then here's a very common occurrence as well. We have a negative times a negative will actually turn into a plus. So we'll have negative 7 times negative b makes positive 7b. So we'll add 7b. You'll look at this guy, see if there's any like terms. There's not. So this is our final answer for this problem. All right. Here's our last example. This one's a little bit more challenging. We actually have two different distributive properties that I see, but one is nested within inside the other one. So one that I see is this 6 times all these things that are being added or subtracted. But then I also see here on the inside, I've got 2 times the quantity y minus 5. We will also need to distribute this 2. So what do we do? Well, I usually like to work from the inside out. I think that's a little safer. So let's worry about this, what's inside the largest brackets, and then we'll take care of the 6 when we're done. So we have x minus 2 times the quantity y minus 5. Let's go ahead and distribute this 2 right here. And let's simplify that before we go any farther. So we'll have 6 times the quantity x, then we'll have minus 2y, because we're distributing the negative 2 to the y, and negative 2 times negative 5 makes plus 10. Okay, so notice, once we've applied the distributive property inside the brackets, the parentheses on the inside are gone, right? We've applied the distributive property. All right, so the last step will be to take care of this distributive property where we multiply the 6 times the x, the 2y, and the 10. Okay, 6 times x is 6x. The 6 times negative 2y would be minus 12y. And the 6 times 10 would be 60. Look for any like terms. I don't think there are any, so I think we're done with this one. All right, now I'm not going to actually go very far with this next example. This will actually come later in the course, but I feel kind of obligated to go ahead and mention it right now. If you have a quantity, I'll just make up a number here. Let's say 4 times a quantity x plus 2 but this quantity is actually squared or cubed. Let's say cubed. Well, we'll say squared. Here, let's say x plus 1 quantity squared. If you have a term times a sum or difference, but this guy is raised to a power higher than 1, like squared or cubed, etc., then you cannot use the distributive property. A lot of students that I have will desperately want to use the distributive property because it looks like the right thing to do, but you cannot distribute the 4 to the x and the 4 to the 1. And the reason, again, is because this is square. So just remember, if you have an exponent up there, that basically locks it down from being able to distribute a number inside those parentheses. Now, that leads to a question we're not going to answer in this video. Now the question would be, well then, Devin, what do we do then? That's going to come later in the course, so I'm not going to take time to talk about that right now. Just for now, know that you are not allowed to distribute if this exponent is anything larger than 1.